give New Yorkers another update on what we are facing as a result of the wildfire smoke from Canada. We have all seen, smell, and the pictures really speaks volumes as you look at the Empire State Building that's engulfed in this smoke. At 5 p.m., the air quality index hit 484, a hazardous condition that we are facing. On the levels of health concern, that is clearly alarming for all New Yorkers. This is the highest level index of our knowledge since the 60s. Conditions are likely to continue to deteriorate through 9 to 10 p.m. tonight, while air quality conditions are anticipated to temporarily improve later tonight through tomorrow morning. They're expected to deteriorate further tomorrow afternoon and evening as smoke moves back over the city. As a result, we are encouraging New Yorkers to stay home indoors tonight and tomorrow whenever possible, especially our vulnerable New Yorkers. All New Yorkers should limit outdoor activity to the greatest extent possible. If you must be outside, we recommend wearing a mask, especially if you are elderly or a younger child.
I feel very bad. At times I can't breathe. It makes breathing difficult. Yeah. I even scheduled for a road test for driving, for my driving license today, and it was canceled. Yeah, I feel very sad. I make sure I stay indoors. Most of the times I make sure I stay indoors. Yeah, I make sure I stay indoors. I don't come outside often.
What about the haze? Well, I'm a little worried about it. I thought yesterday it was going to be a storm. I thought it was a storm coming in, and then we started seeing the air quality indexes. So today was it. We had a big debate before the kids went to school about should we be wearing masks today. All their activities are indoors today. So on one hand, I'm glad it should be temporary, but a little worried about what they're breathing up today.
I wear the mask because I hear about the smoke is coming from Canada, and they say it's very dangerous. So that's why I started using again.
As I said this morning, this is a climate change. This is climate change in action, and we must continue to draw down emissions, improve air quality, and build resiliency. Our city is strong and resilient. We have faced crises before, and we will get through this together.
Finally, I look out the window, and I see what everyone else sees, the yellow, red sky, the obscured skyline. In many ways, it brings back memories, both through sight and through smell, of my visits to India throughout my youth. I've been saying to folks today, it feels like Delhi in a hot day in June. If you feel anxious, if you feel worried, that's totally understandable. If you just need to talk and be reassured, call 988. Support is standing by. We have to take each situation clearly, but this is extremely dangerous air outside. This is an environment where we are recommending every single New Yorker, if they don't have to, stay indoors. That's a very strong recommendation. And for us to make that recommendation, the quality of the air must be extremely poor. What is the result of that? Lung conditions exacerbated, heart conditions exacerbated, mucosal membranes from the eyes, the nose, the ears, irritated, burning, throat burning. So we recommend stay indoors. It's the safest way. This is an extremely high level. As the mayor said, we haven't seen levels like this in decades. We also haven't seen levels rise this quickly, this suddenly, over the last 24 hours, almost ever. Because, frankly, we don't get wildfire smoke here in this way like this.